This is about heroin, which is not the funniest topic in the world. I don't know, that's why I was excited to do it, is just to try something different. And when I heard that she was doing it, that made me more comfortable because I knew we'd both be terrified.
Yeah, it was cool that it was kind of both of our first experience doing something darker, but also the pace and the frantic night. All the things going on, kind of, there is a little humor. There's definitely a humor aspect to it, but that adds to the humor.
It's so heavy that I think, I don't want to talk for Marja, but I think...
I love being spoken for.
I think the reason maybe you were interested in us is because you didn't want it to just be this heavy thing that just takes you out the whole way through. It's like, it's nice to have a little bit of levity where we play brother and sister and where we still can, like, make fun of each other throughout and have those tiny moments of humor that cut up the darkness.
I also think that, like, for me, it was like their shared, like, sense of humor makes them feel like brother and sister.
Right.
It, like, gives them this, like, shared history. It feels like they grew up together. Just, you know, some Jews.
Couple of Jews, and you're all related.
Yeah.
Big criteria for me when I'm choosing a project is I want to only take on things that feel like they're doing something new. And of course, we've seen movies about heroin addicts before, but I had never seen one about a guy who's from an upper middle class family, who has a nice loving family, who seemingly has no reason to, like, you know, start doing heroin. And in reality, those are a lot of the people out there who are doing it right now.
I'm from outside Philadelphia, upper middle class area, and was around a lot of people that overdosed. And so I was, like, unfortunately pretty familiar with this. I hadn't ever really thought that I would be a part of telling a story about that, because it was something I, like, try not to think about that much, but I was really happy to be a part of telling that story. Yeah, and a big part of the film is sort of like, why is this happening to you and us? Like, we have everything, like, why is this happening? Like, you don't need to be doing this. And I think that it's rampant in all sort of classes. So it's important to be talking about it.
Yeah, it's based on, like, a true story. One of my best friends who produced the movie, Sam Houseman, she had a night that was not unlike the night that's depicted in the movie. And with her brother, who had a 6-month-old daughter with him at the time. I aged the kid up so I could, like, talk to her. But, yeah, everything's pretty real. And the fact that, like, the two of them were, like, very generous with their time, and Dave spent a lot of time with Sam's brother, John, and he, like, walked him through, like, the physicality of what it looks like to be high. Because that's the other thing, too. Like, when you see, like, movies about drugs, like, something doesn't feel quite right a lot of the times. Like, it feels like 2-2. And to actually have someone, like, talk you through it and be like, no, I was a practicing lawyer, like, while I was on heroin. Mm-hmm. So it doesn't look like that. It looks like this. It looks like this on me. Like, at some point, it's to function. And, like, it's the withdrawing that's actually the problem. But he, like, really walked us through everything, and he was really generous.
I couldn't have done it without him. Yeah. It was because the whole movie takes place in one day. It's like I'm coming down from heroin
in real time, basically.
Yes, and then at one point I'm going back up, and it's just subtle differences throughout the day. I'm like, okay, 5 hours into withdrawal, what does it look like? 10 hours, 12 hours, what does it look like? Just the subtle changes, and I couldn't have done it without his help. Yeah,
it was pretty incredible watching Dave do this part, because it so much of it was also about, you know, there's a whole world just in terms of, like, mannerisms around the drug and operating. He transformed himself. Dave looks very different in the movie.
I'll say disgusting.
Yeah.
Every day you would walk by me, you look disgusting. Then we would high five and go our way.
It was just a very, it was a very intense experience,
yeah.
I think, for
yeah,
you.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah, I lost 20 to 25 pounds, and I'm not the biggest guy as is.
He was 118 pounds. We weighed the same, like, coming out that shoot. You know what I mean?
It was pretty gnarly. I've never been the type of actor who, like, goes home at the end of the day and is like, oh, I can't get rid of the part. But, like, when you lose that much weight, it affects you. And I was depressed, and, like, I would come home and my wife would be like, you're not yourself, you're not fun to be around. And I'm like, I'm fucking starving. What do you want from me? And I'm glad I did it. You know, it was definitely the most challenging role I've ever done, but I don't think I need to transform myself physically like that for a while. Well, halfway through filming, I was so depressed that I booked a trip to New York for the day after we finished, and I just had my food trip in New York, and I overdid it and got sick, but it felt good.
Like, eat, pray, love, you know?
Yes.
Yeah.